In this video, we are going to discuss about instruction formats. We know that program means a collection of instructions. Each instruction is represented with the help of instruction format. Mainly, instruction format is classified into three fields. The first field of instruction format is address field. The second field is opcode field. Third field is mode field. First, let's see the first one, address field. Address field specifies address of the operand. Generally, operand resides either in memory or register. So, address field specifies address of the memory or address of the register. Next one is opcode field. Opcode field specifies operation that is to be performed. So which operation we are performing, that is to be specified by opcode field. Next field, mode field. Mode field specifies how an operand or effective address is determined. We perform operations on some data. The data resides in effective address. That effective address is determined with the help of mode field. We will discuss more about mode field in addressing modes concept. In the next video, we will see about addressing modes. Next, we have several operations. Opcode field specifies operations. We will discuss all those operations in the upcoming videos, such as in this chapter only. We have data transfer instructions, data manipulation instruction, program control instructions. All those are nothing but operations. So we will discuss all those three in the upcoming videos. So in this video, our major focus is on address fields. So based upon the number of addresses, there are three types of organizations are there. Based upon the number of addresses, we can classify them into three types of organization. The first one is single accumulator organization. So we know what is accumulator. Accumulator is a register. Single accumulator organization. And the second one is general purpose register organization. Whereas the third one is stack organization. So let's see about the first one. The first one is single accumulator organization. Here accumulator is implicit one. There is no need to specify accumulator explicitly. Automatically depends upon the instruction, accumulator will be taken as one operand. If you take an example, CLA. CLA stands for clear accumulator, but this instruction doesn't contain any operand. So whenever CLA is executed, then the content of the accumulator will be cleared. If you take CMA, CMA stands for complement accumulator. Here also accumulator is implicit one. So whenever this instruction is executed, then the content of the accumulator will be complemented. If you take one more example like add X. So we know that we can perform add operation on two numbers, but here we have only X. So what is the second operand? The second operand resides in accumulator. So here X means memory location. So whenever this instruction is executed, then accumulator is the implicit one. So the content of the accumulator will be added to the memory board yet address X. So M stands for memory board yet address X. Let X is 1000. So 1000. Let at 1000 we have 5. So 1000 means X. M of 1000 means 5. So the content of accumulator will be added to this one. And the result is transferred to the accumulator. So this is about single accumulator organization. And the second one is general purpose register organization. General purpose register organization means the corresponding instruction contains multiple addresses. Here the addresses may be either registers or some memory operands or some combinations of everything, addresses and memory like that. Let us take an example. Let us say some examples. For general purpose register organization, add R1, R2, R3. So that we have three registers like this. So whenever this instruction is executed, so the content of R1, R2 and R3 will be added and the result is transferred to R1. So here R1 acts as source register and destination register. So here there are three registers. So this is a general purpose register organization. Or we can write as something like this, add R1, R2. Let R1 acts as both source and destination registers. Then R1 plus R2 will be added and the corresponding result is transferred to R1. Let us take an example like this, move R2. So whenever this statement is executed, then the content of R2 will be transferred to R1. So this is nothing but a general purpose register. Here not only registers, we can take addresses also, we can take memory operands also. Let us take an example like this, add R1, X. So the contents of R1 will be added to the memory board at address X and that result will be transferred to R1. So the content of R1 will be added to memory board at address X and the result is transferred to R1. So this is nothing but general purpose register organization. We have to use just multiple addresses. Those addresses may be either registers or operands. Now let's see the next one, stack organization. In stack organization, we use instructions like push instruction, pop instruction, and if you want to perform arithmetic operations, then we use instructions like add, sub, mul, div like that. We will discuss all these in, we have zero address instructions. In zero address instructions, we will discuss all the stack related instructions. Here, based upon the number of addresses, we can classify the instructions into five types. The first one is three address instruction. Second one is two address instruction. Third one is one address instruction. Fourth one is zero address instruction. And the fifth one is RISC instruction. Now let's take an instruction and represent that instruction with the help of three address instruction, two address instruction, one address instruction, as well as zero address instruction. Let the instruction is like this, x is equal to a plus b into c plus d. So this is an expression. So first we have to evaluate a plus b, next we have to evaluate c plus d and perform multiplication operation. Why? Because we know that parenthesis has higher precedency than star. For parenthesis, the associativity is from left to right. So first this expression is evaluated, next this expression, next star will be evaluated and the corresponding result is stored in x. Let us represent this equation, let us represent this statement with the help of three address instruction. Okay, three address instruction. The name itself specifies the meaning. Three address means the corresponding instruction contains three addresses. It may be either registers or some memory address. Let us evaluate the first instruction. Here we have A and B. We have only two addresses, but here how many addresses we need? Three addresses. So let us store the result in a register. So add R1 comma A comma B. So whenever the statement is executed, then the memory board at address is added to memory board at address B and the corresponding result is transferred to a register called R1. Now R1 contains the result of A plus B. Now let us evaluate C plus D. So add C comma D. So now transfer that result to a register called R2. So what this instruction will do? Add the memory board at address C and the memory board at address D and transfer the result to R2. So what is the statement? Let C be some 500. So C means 500, 5000. Let C be 5000. Let M of 5000 is 10. So C means this address 5000, whereas M of 5000 means the memory board, the operand at 5000, that is 10. Okay. So where that result is available in R2. So this instruction contains three address, this instruction contains two address, three addresses. Next we have to perform multiplication operation on these two expressions. A plus B result is available in R1.
C plus D result is available in R2. So perform multiplication operation on R1 and R2 and move the result to X. So mul. So here what is X? So this is nothing but X comma R1 comma R2. So perform multiplication operation on R1 and R2 and move the result to X. Here what is X? X means memory location. So we have to store the result in that memory location. So we have to use M of X. So M of X means the memory word at address X. So at address X, this value will be stored. Okay. So this is about three address instruction. So next, what we have to do? We have to represent that statement with the help of two address instruction. If you take this one, the first instruction contains three addresses. Second instruction contains two addresses. Third instruction contains three addresses. Now we have to solve this problem. We have to represent the statement with the help of two addresses. Here in this we use a move instruction. Okay. So let us move A to a register called R1. So move R1 comma A. So whenever this here, if you take this one, here we have two addresses. The first address is R1, second address is A. Here the first one is destination register, second one is source register. So whenever the statement is executed, then the memory word at address A is moved to R1 register. So now A is available in R1. So we have to add B to R1. Okay. So let us use add here. So add, already A value is available in R1. So add R1 comma B. So whenever the statement is executed, B is added to R1. What is R1? R1 is nothing but A only. So what will happen now? So R1 will be added to the memory board at address B and the result is moved to R1. So now R1 contains the result of A plus B. So likewise, we have to perform C plus D and we need to store the result in the next register, that is R2. So next we have to move. C to R2. So what is the meaning of this statement? So move the memory board at address C to R2. So now R2 contains the content of C. So now what we have to do? We have to add B to R2. So add. So already R2 contains that result. So we add R2 comma D. So whenever the statement is executed, then R2 will be added to M of D. And the result is moved to R2. So now R2 contains the result of C plus D. So which operation we have to perform? We have to perform multiplication operation. So perform multiplication operation on R1 and R2. So R1 implies arrow R1 into R2. Now this R1 contains this entire result. So now we have to move that result to X. So move X comma R1. Then what will happen? R1 arrow M of X. So the content of R1 will be moved to the memory board at address X. If you take this one, every instruction contains how many addresses? Two addresses. So that's why this is an example for two address instruction. So two address means we have to make use of move and some arithmetic instructions. Now let us focus on one address instruction. So we have to represent the statement with the help of one address instruction. One address instruction means we have to make use of load instruction and store instruction. The meaning of load is load memory board to accumulator, whereas the meaning of store is store accumulator into memory. So first we have A. So load A. So here the instruction contains how many addresses? Only one address. So the meaning of load is load memory board to accumulator. Now A content is available in accumulator. Now we have to add B to accumulator. So let us use add B. So what will happen now? Accumulator content is added to the memory board at address P and the result is moved to accumulator. Now accumulator contains the result of A plus B. Now we have to load this memory board to accumulator. If we load this C to accumulator, then this content will be destroyed. So that's why we have to store this accumulator in a temporary memory location. So for that I am using T. So T stands for temporary memory location. So the meaning of store is store accumulator into memory. So the content of the accumulator will be loaded to the memory location. What is the memory location?
So the memory would at address T. Okay.
Now A plus B result is available in this D memory location. Now let us perform C plus D.
So load C. So load C means what will happen? The memory would at C will be loaded to accumulator.
Next, we have to perform add operation.
So add D. So whenever we perform add D, then what will happen? The content of the accumulator will be added to the memory board at address D, and that content will be moved to accumulator.
So now this accumulator contains C plus D result, whereas this A plus B result is available in T. So now what we have to do? We have to perform which operation? Multiplication operation.
So multi.
So if we perform multi, then what will happen? Accumulator is the implied one.
So the content of the accumulator will be multiplied with the memory board at address T, and that result is moved to accumulator.
So now accumulator contains this entire result. So now we have to store that result in X.
So for that we have an instruction called store. So store X.
So what is the meaning of store? Store accumulator into memory.
So this accumulator content will be stored in memory. So now the result is available in memory.
So in this way we can represent this statement with the help of one address instruction. Now let's see about zero address instruction. So we have to represent this equation with the help of zero address instruction.
Zero address instruction means we have to make use of stack. So here we will use as instructions like push instruction, pop instruction, arithmetic instructions like add, sub, mul, like that.
Here if you want to represent this statement with the help of zero address instruction, we have to represent this expression in postfix notation.
So first here A plus B will be evaluated. So in postfix expression it is AB plus. Next this expression will be evaluated. In postfix it is like this CB plus. Next multiplication will be performed on this and this expression. Okay.
So first, what is the first one? A.
So push A. If it is an operand, then push it onto the stack.
Whereas if it is an operator, then pop the topmost two operands from the stack, perform the operation and push the result onto the stack.
So A, so this is an operand, so A will be pushed onto the top of the stack. So here we have A, so this is nothing but top of the stack.
Okay.
Next, what is the next one? B. It is an operand, so we have to push it onto the top of the stack. Okay. So B will be pushed onto the top of the stack. So now TOS points to B. So now TOS points to B.
Next we have plus. So plus means
addition operation. Here there is no need of any address.
So addition means what will happen? If it is an operator, then we have to pop the topmost two operands, perform the operation and push the result onto the stack.
So B will be popped, A will be popped. Okay. What is the operation plus? So A plus B will be performed, and it will be pushed onto the top of the stack. Okay. So TOS, the result of A plus B. I am using some parenthesis. Parenthesis represents the result of A and B, the result of A plus B. Okay.
Next we have C.
C is an operand, so push it onto the top of the stack. So C, TOS. Now what is TOS? C. So now TOS is at C location. Next we have D. So push D. It is an operand, so push it onto the top of the stack. So now D is pushed, TOS points to D.
Next we have plus. Plus is an operator, addition operator. If it is an operator, then we have to pop the topmost two operands.
So D will be popped as well as C will be popped. So which operation we are doing? C plus D. So C, and push that result onto the top, onto the stack. Okay. So yeah. So what is the result? TOS, C plus D.
Next we have star. So star means an operator.
So multiplication. Okay.
So what will happen? This will be popped and this will be popped.
C plus D is popped, A plus B is popped, and multiplication is performed. TOS implies C plus D into A plus B, and that result is pushed to top of the stack. So now top of stack contains this result. Okay.
That result.
C plus D into A plus B.
C plus D into A plus B is nothing but what? A plus B into C plus B only. There is no problem.
Next, we have to store that result in S. So for that we use pop.
So whenever we use pop, then the stack's topmost element will be popped.
So what is the stack's topmost element? TOS. So it will be popped and it will be stored at memory location X, M of X.
So in this way we can represent with the help of zero address instruction.
Now let us represent this equation with the help of the last one, that is RISC instruction. RISC stands for Reduced Instruction Set Computer. We will discuss more about RISC in the upcoming videos. We have a concept called RISC and CISC. In that we will see more about RISC and CISC. Reduced Instruction Set Computer. So RISC means here mainly we use load and store instructions. Mainly the operations are performed on the registers. So let us use load and store. So load, let us load R1 to A. So the memory word at A will be loaded to R1 register. So likewise load B to R2. So load R2 comma B. So the memory word at B will be loaded to R2 register. Next one, load R3 comma C. So the memory word at C will be loaded to R3. Next, load R4 comma D. So the memory word at D will be loaded to R4. Okay. Next, what we have to do? We have to perform A and B. A result is available in R1, whereas B result is available in R2. So let us perform add operation. So add. So already we have watched R1 and R2. So let us take. Consider one of them as destination register. Let us consider R1 as the destination register. So the content of R1 and R2 is added and the result is moved to R1. So now R1 contains the result of A plus B. So likewise we add R3 comma R4. So now what will happen? R3 plus R4 will be added. R3 and R4 will be added and the result is moved to R3. So next, this result is available in R1, this result is available in R3. So perform multiplication operation. So mul R1 comma R3. So R1 into R3, store the result in R1. Okay. So next, we have to store this result in X. So store X comma R1. So this R1 result will be stored in this X memory location. So this is about RISC. RISC means mainly we use just load, store and some multiplication arithmetic instructions. Mainly we perform operations on the registers so that with less amount of time the operation will be performed. We know that registers are very, very faster. So this is about instruction formats.